Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Friday of the week of Pentecost, 11, 21 August, the reading Nathan Soderblom, 1866-1931, a pastoral letter. Faith in the resurrection by no means rests upon something comprehended, on something negative, on an emptiness, on an open grave which no longer hides a dead body. Faith in the resurrection rests upon something positive, on a miracle, on what the disciples and the women experienced when their minds, like the body of their beloved master, were enveloped in darkness. Faith in the resurrection rests on Christ's appearances to his followers. Here, too, the field is open to the honest efforts of the human mind to relate these appearances and revelations to our universal experiences and to scientific conclusions reached in similar or allied occurrences. But it would do us very little good to study these efforts in the hope that they might throw additional light on the manner in which the disciples, through a divine intervention, a miracle of God, arose out of the grave of disappointment and despair to a new and transfigured experience. The fact remains, and if it is difficult for science to interpret it, this does not justify anyone in striking it from the annals of the race as being impossible and inconceivable. Were this done, the entire history of the world since the coming of Christ would have to be fundamentally altered. The prayer, Floyd W. Tompkins, 1850-1932. With thee, O Christ, we would arise indeed to newness of life. We beseech thee to make all things new to us. Let the old duties, the old work, the old burdens, the old friendships be transfigured as thou dost touch them. Let the resurrection joy lift us from loneliness and weakness and despair to strength and beauty and happiness. We would fain live the risen life. Help us by thy call, by thy message, by thy beauty, by thy goodness, to be thy true children, looking to thee and serving thee until at last we see thee face to face. Amen.